Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, brothers and sisters, family, colleagues, contemporaries, and well-wishers of Grace Tenkorang, on whose account we have gathered this morning to celebrate her Christian funeral, to commend her to God Almighty. I welcome you to St. Boniface Church for this final rite as we bid her farewell. We pray that this ceremony will renew our faith and spur us to spare a thought for Grace today, and indeed all those we know who have died. In waters of baptism, Grace died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. We're now praying. Just before that, please keep our phones on. We do not put them in silence, but just switch them on. Almighty God and Father, there's a certain faith that your Son, who died on the cross, was raised from the dead. The first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery, your servant, Grace, who has gone to her rest in Christ, may share the joy of his resurrection. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Please let's be seated.
But they are in peace. If they experience punishment as men see it, their hope was rich with immortality. Slight was their affliction, great were their blessings. God has put them to the test and proved them worthy to be with him. He has tested them like gold in the furnace and accepted them as a holocaust. When the time comes for his visitation, they will shine out. As sparks run through the stubble, so will they. They shall judge nations, rule over peoples, and the Lord will be their king forever. They who trust in him will understand the truth. Those who are faithful will live with him in love, for grace and mercy await those who he has chosen. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm. The response will be, I shall walk in the valley of darkness, No evil would I fear, for you are with me.
I shall walk in the valley of darkness. No evil would I fear, for you are with me.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures, where he leads me repose. Near restful waters he leads me, to revive my drooping spirit. He guides me along the right path. He is true to his name. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear. You are there with your crew and with your staff, with those who give me comfort. You have prepared a banquet for me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil, my cup is overflowing. No evil will I fear, for you are there with me. Surely, goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever and ever. Shall we stand for the gospel of provision, please? Hallelujah, hallelujah. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still, and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I'm going now to prepare a place for you. And after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Let's be seated. When you deserve nothing, when you merit no reward, when you get a promotion without any effort of yours, we describe that as grace. And this has been defined as unmerited favor. Today, grace lays before the sanctuary of God as we bid her farewell spiritually. Yesterday evening, something happened that I've never seen before. I only saw see that when a bishop dies. That's why I felt this woman is a woman that is indeed blessed. When a priest dies or a bishop dies, the body of the priest is kept in the church overnight. And every hour, mass is said for the bishop or the priest till morning. This woman is no priest. This woman is no bishop. But by, we don't call it accident of history, by providence, it happens that those who are supposed to bring their cups today, we are occupied for the time they are supposed to bring it. On account of that, the only way they could bring it was to bring it the night before. And she slept in the house of God till now. Grace is her name. That is grace. She shared in the privilege that is reserved for those who serve in the sanctuary of the Lord, what we call Holy of Holies. What a greater gift could she receive? What a greater sign that she is at peace could we look for? We have gathered here today to celebrate this woman whose name took flesh even on the day of her funeral. Why do we need to pray for the dead? After all, they are dead. Why do we gather to pray for the dead? If you remember your Bible very correctly, when Jesus engaged the Pharisees in that banter, when they said to him, it was by the power of Beelzebub that he cast out devil. He said to them, if you sin against me, it can be forgiven. But if you sin against the Holy Spirit, it can neither be forgiven here or hereafter. That gives an indication that prayer can change things even after death. And so we gather here to pray. To pray to God to receive our soul into heaven. To forgive her of her earthly failings. And to grant her eternal peace. We have come here for this one person. This one person who has a lot of friends and perhaps a lot of enemies. This one person who has done a lot of things well while he was on earth, but perhaps a lot of things wrong with him. That person is not grace. That person is Jesus. It's because of Jesus that we're here. To turn away from him is to fall. To return to him is to rise again. To remain in him is to be secure. In him we derive our breath, our life, and meaning. And we are told today, he's the way, he's the truth, he's the life. The three things we are looking for. We are all looking for a way for our life to be better. We are searching for truth that will give meaning to our life. We are looking for life that is fulfilled. Jesus is the way that is interminable, not incontaminated that way. Jesus is the life that is invaluable. It cannot be destroyed. Jesus is eternal life, and Jesus is the truth that is infallible. On his account, we celebrate our sister today. So we look back in thanksgiving for the life she lived, for the life she touched as a good woman, down to earth, caring, loving, peaceful, amicable, sacrificial. And that woman, she has died, but she lives on through her good works. Monuments, what are they? What are monuments? The great pyramids have forgotten their builders. All these skyscrapers in the world, even this church, they've forgotten their builders. Deeds, not stones, are the true monument of the great. And even in death, her deeds live on. That's her monument, her good deeds. We pray in thanksgiving today at the Mass, which is reuniting ourselves in the sacrifice of Christ on the cross 2,000 years ago. And this is happening in Easter season, after Easter that she's been buried. And she's grace in every way. And we look to the future in hope. My dear friends, grace has paid her dues. She has made her mark. And she has gone to the life beyond. Scripture said that lifespan is 70. She has reached 70 and even more. And 80 for those who are strong. Without God, all of this are emptiness. We pass and we are gone. Now that we are here, what can we learn from life? What about us? On the day we are born, we are old enough to die. Every day we live is grace. Let us not take anything for granted. We go to bed and we wake up. Any day God does not call your name, you will not wake up. Genesis says, evening came and morning came the next day. In this particular day, God did not call Grace and she's gone. Let us because God calls you by your name. Bismarck, wake up. Louisa, wake up. Anthony, wake up. And that's why we are here. One day will come, and our name will not be called. Will we be ready? What kind of legacy are we living? What kind of life are we living? What kind of life are we living? Are we taking things for granted? Are we keeping enmity and quarrels and unforgiveness and hurts in our hearts? What does this season of coronavirus teach us? That life is so fickle. Life is so short. And only thing that makes life meaningful is God. Long life may be good enough. It may not be good, a long life, or may not be long enough. People may not live for long, but good life is always long enough. So if we have a long life, it's not good enough. But any good life is always long enough. I repeat, long life may not be good enough, but good life is always long enough, even if it is short. Let us be here today making a commitment to live a better life, to show love, to forgive those who have hurt us, to reconcile ourselves with friends and people all over, and realize that what matters the most is love. And the true measure of life is love. My dear friends, we commend Grace's soul to God's care. We pray that God will forgive her of her earthly failings. She's a practicing Catholic, as we say in the Catholic Church, practicing Catholic, meaning that her faith was not perfected yet. And all practicing Catholic, from the priest to all the people, we are all practicing the faith. And that's why we come bring her here to pray for her. That God in Jesus will perfect everything that she couldn't complete until she died. And so it is for all of us who are Christians or who are children of God. Even if we are not Christians or not believers, one day the trumpet will sound and we will say goodbye. We will go to a dream, and that dream will not wake up from it. We pray that God will make our life more meaningful, more purposeful, more God-centered, more simple than anything else. This is our prayer to Christ, our Lord. Amen. We shall now have the beginning prayer for Grace and for all of us gathered. Let us pray and commend the soul of Grace to God's care, that God will grant her a place in heaven. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
For Grace, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may be admitted to the company of the saints. Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the children and family of Grace, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for those who are suffering from health challenges, that they may find the strength and courage to overcome their illness and keep faith in the Lord. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us make our personal prayers to God in silence. We now ask the Blessed Virgin Mary to intercede for us as we pray.
Amen. 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 Amen
Angela, who is deceased, and grant them the fullness of your redemption. We also pray for our other children, Gladys, Bismarck, and Michael, and your grace will continue to abide with them through Christ our Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
by sending down your spirit upon them like the dewfall. That they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate this mystery. On the night he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, John, our Bishop, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Remember your daughter, Grace, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like this may be also one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, Lord, who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your grace. Have mercy on us all, we pray. Now the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, my spouse, Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, the mighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we'll be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant all peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us offer each other by bow a sign of peace.
Peace be with you. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. I only to say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Whoever believes in me, even though she dies, we live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will not die. Hallelujah. The body of Christ.
Amen.
Thank you.
us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your daughter, Grace, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And I invite, let's be seated, please. I invite this man, the people, for their tribute.
Tribute by children. Why you downcast, oh my soul disturbed within me? Put your hope in God, for I will yet praise Him, my Savior and my God. My soul downcast within me, therefore I remember you from the land of the Jordan, the height of Hermon, from mountain in Israel. Psalm 42, verses 5 to 6. Mother, Mesh Grace Tenkorang, we call, but no response. It is sad, but God knows best, Mother. You were the strength of life, the rock of the family. A gentle heartbeat to us, your children, and an inspiration too. We attribute all our success in our lives to the moral, intellectual, and physical education we receive from you. You were the woman you look up to. Your Christian life was not a joke to you, and you encourage us to keep the right path, just as every good mother will do to his children. We miss thee, O Mother. Your image is still and will forever remain in the deepest part of our hearts. Thank you, Mom, for all you did for us. Thank you again, and may your soul rest in perfect peace. Amen.
The final commendation. Before we go our separate ways, let us think, our sister, let us pray that God will bless her and keep her and sustain her. Let us rise. I know that my deliverance and the final day, his voice shall make me rise again, and every joy and season praise. This hope I cherish in my heart, to stand on earth, my flesh restored, and not a stranger, but a friend, before my Savior and my Lord. Let us pray. To you, O Lord, we commend the soul of your daughter, Grace. In the sight of this world, she is now dead. In your sight, may she live forever. Forgive whatever sins she committed through human weakness, and in your goodness, grant her everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
ladies and gentlemen, we are now getting ready to go to the cemetery. So stay tuned. Thank you. ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to go off now, and when we get to the cemetery, I'll start again. So I'm going off. Still come back to Dwumfour, go to Dwumfour TV in the next about 20 minutes. And we should be at the cemetery, and then we can continue with the interment or the burial. Thank you very much. So I'm going off now. I'll come back. Just go to Dwumfour TV, and then you'll see the part two of Mrs. Grace Tenkorang's funeral. Thank you.